Welcome back YouTube, I have Ahmed again from In-Depth Tech Reviews, and in today's video I'm gonna do a comparison between a stock Android 11 and the iOS 14. So if you are thinking about switching from one OS to the other, this video will help you decide which one is better for you. I did the same comparison between a stock Android 10 and the iOS 13 last year, and since then Google and Apple added a lot of new features and refinements to their operating systems. So it's time to take another look to see which operating system is better, but before getting started, let's make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time I post a new video. So let's jump in. Now let's start with the look and feel. Once I unlocked my iPhone 12 Pro Max, I started to see how good the animations are in iOS in every action I take, like launching and quitting apps, navigating the recent apps screen, checking my notifications, scrolling, haptic touch, and more. Overall, it feels a lot smoother in iOS than stock Android. The second thing I liked in iOS is the home indicator or the small bar at the bottom of the screen. In iOS, it floats over apps and it looks the same way in every single app, but in Android, there are some inconsistencies. Sometimes it floats over apps like in iOS, sometimes you see a black bar at the bottom of the screen, and sometimes you see a thin line that separates between the app and the home indicator, so Android lacks consistency here. Next, the icons and widgets. In iOS, they have a subtle 3D effect that gives more depth between the icons and the background, while in Android, they are totally flat. In my opinion, iOS approach gives a better visual experience, especially when I use a colorful wallpaper. In stock Android, it feels a little bit messy and it's hard for my eyes to differentiate between the icons and the background, while on iOS, it looks just fine. That's why on my Android phone, I always use minimal wallpapers with one or two colors maximum, and sometimes I use a third-party app to blur the background and add extra depth between the two. Also, Apple used the same compact design of Android in iOS 14, so now Siri and the phone app have better designs in my opinion. So overall, when it comes to the look and feel, the win goes to iOS 14. This doesn't mean that stock Android 11 has a bad design. I do like the simplicity of the stock Android, but the lack of consistency in the animations and the overall design is the main reason why I chose iOS over stock Android in this category. Now let's talk about the system navigation. And in this category, Android was a lot better for me, and here is why. In iOS, the control center and the notifications are separated, which requires two different swipes to access each one, while in Android, with one swipe, you get access to both at once, which is easier and less confusing. I understand that you can add your HomeKit devices to the control center, and that could be the reason why the notification center and the control center are separated to have more space. But with Android 11, when I press and hold on the power button, I get the new power menu that includes the power controls, the Google Pay cards, and my smart devices all together. If we're gonna compare that to iOS, to power off my phone, I have to press and hold on the power and the volume down keys. To get my Apple Pay cards, I have to double press the power button. And to get access to the smart devices, I need to go to the control center. So these are three different things versus only one press for all on Android. Next, accessing the app library and app drawer. In iOS, it requires me to scroll all the way to the right, so if I have 3, 4, or 5 pages in my home screen, it will be annoying. In Android, to access the app drawer, you simply need to swipe up from the home screen, while on iOS, the swipe up gesture is not even utilized. Next, there are a couple of things that annoyed me while navigating iOS. For example, there is no shortcut for the settings in the control center or the notifications shade like in Android. So every time I need to change something, I have to look for the settings icon or use the spotlight search. Some buttons like cancel are always located at the very top, and to tap on it, I had to use the reachability gesture or two hands as usual. In Android, with a simple swipe from any of the edges, I can cancel or get back one step, which is easier. This doesn't mean that Android is perfect, but it has a couple of issues as well. The back gesture sometimes overlaps with the horizontal scrolling, so you might accidentally go back one step. Accessing the hamburger menu using the peek gesture on Android also overlaps with the back gesture sometimes. But I'm glad that Google started to remove the hamburger menu from some apps like Google Photos and Google Maps to work better with the gesture navigation. As an alternative, I can use the three buttons navigation on Android 11 to overcome this issue, but it's not a big deal for me, so I will stick with the gesture navigation for now. Overall, in the system navigation category, the win goes to Android 11, as it was easier to use and required less steps to navigate. Now let's talk about multitasking. In iOS 14, Apple added the picture-in-picture feature, which is already available on Android for years, but in iOS it's limited only to FaceTime calls and playing videos, while in Android it's part of a bigger feature called Display Over Apps. This feature allows you to have floating chat heads like in Facebook Messenger. You can use picture-in-picture with videos, you can use it with Google Maps, it gives you the ability to use floating keyboards, and more. The only advantage in iOS is the picture-in-picture is easier to use while playing videos. First, it supports pinch to zoom, you can dock the window to any of the sides and get it back easily. Finally, it has more sizes to choose from. In Android, you can resize the picture-in-picture window by dragging your finger on any of the corners, no pinch to zoom support. It has less sizes to choose from, and when you hide it, you have to reopen the app and close it again to get it back, which is inconvenient. The second thing to talk about is the split screen, and this is one of the features that I love in Android. It helps me a lot in calculating my budget, shop for products while watching videos, and more. It's a shame that Apple didn't add the split screen feature in iOS 14. The iPhone 12 Pro Max I have here has a 6.7 inches display, which is almost the same size of a tablet, so the split screen on it will be very useful. Overall, when it comes to multitasking, the win goes to Android 11, because you get the Display Over Apps feature, which is more capable than the picture-in-picture feature of iOS 14, in addition to the split screen. Now let's talk about managing notifications. In this category, Android was better than iOS in most cases. In Android 11, the notifications are categorized in three different categories: silent, default, and priority. Silent are the notifications that don't make any sound or vibration, but you still can see them in the notifications shade. The default notifications are the exact opposite to silent, and the priority gives you the ability to set certain conversations within your messaging apps to always notify you, even if the Do Not Disturb is active. These notifications will always appear at the top of your notifications list, and you will be able to see the profile picture of the contact in your status bar. On the other hand, iOS 14 has only two types, either the normal or quiet notifications. Both work the same way as Android, but it doesn't have the priority option, and I couldn't find a way to mimic the same behavior on iOS. Next, Android 11 has the notification history feature, which doesn't exist in iOS 14. This feature allows me to check my dismissed notifications up to 24 hours back. So if I dismissed any by mistake, or if I don't remember the app that sent me a specific one, I can easily check that in the history. Next, Android Smart Replies, which also doesn't exist in iOS. Smart Replies allows me to quickly reply to messages while doing other things without touching the keyboard. But I only found one thing that iOS 14 does better in this category, which is the ability to listen to voice messages from your notifications. So overall, the win goes to Android 11 in managing notifications because of the more features I have. Now let's talk about messaging, and here I'm referring to the native messaging apps. With Android 11, Google Messages now supports RCS messaging, which is the same thing as iMessage. But the question is, which one is better? For me, I'm not using any of them because I would rather go for a cross-platform messaging app like WhatsApp or Telegram over an app that only works on one operating system. But if we're gonna compare both, I see iMessage should be the winner because it has more features like Memoji, Animoji, Digital Touch, and the bubble effects. While Google Messages offers only the basic functionalities like sending stickers and GIFs, but the only advantage Google Messages has is the ability to use it through the web. So you can check your messages and chat with others on any computer with a web browser. Now let's talk about the apps and games. When it comes to games, iOS was a lot better. I even subscribed to Apple Arcade and Google Play Pass to get the most out of each operating system, and I found that iOS exclusive games are better and more fun to play. Even if the same game is available on both operating systems, the iOS version will always have better graphics. When it comes to apps, the iOS version usually has better design, but this is not a big deal as far as both apps function the same way. But the advantage Android has is most of the apps and games are free, but you have to deal with the ads. Overall, when it comes to apps and games, iOS has better quality, but Android is more wallet-friendly, so I will call this one a draw. Now let's talk about the virtual assistant, or in other words, Google Assistant versus Siri. But it requires a separate video, so if you didn't check my previous video about Siri on iOS 14 versus the new Google Assistant, you can click the link showing now on the screen or in the description below. Just to sum up everything, Google Assistant is way smarter and it can be integrated with more services, so the win goes to Android in this category. Now let's talk about the ease of use. And here I will go through a lot of generic features that make my life easier while using my Android phone and how things changed after switching to iOS. So let's start with the things that Android does better. In Android 11, I can have the media controls of multiple apps in my quick settings area, scroll through them, and resume playing from whatever app I want without the need to open this app, which is something I couldn't do in iOS. In Android, I can copy text from the recent app's screen, which is very useful in cases where the app I'm using does not support copying. iOS widgets are not interactive like in Android. For example, the calendar widget allows me to scroll through the months and tap on the day I want to quickly jump to that day in the calendar app. While in iOS, no matter where I tap on the widget, it will keep opening the app on today's date. Other widgets in Android support scrolling, which is also not available in iOS. In iOS, I miss Android's Now Playing feature. It automatically identifies songs in the background and stores the names for me to check later. And with the latest feature drop, I can multi-select the previously identified songs and create a playlist in YouTube Music. While in iOS, your only options are Shazam or Siri, and in some cases, the song playing might end before you even make your Music ID app ready. So the Now Playing feature is very useful and convenient. Now let's talk about the home screen for a second. Once I started using my iPhone, I wanted to reorganize my apps and make everything the way I want. But I knew that I will face a hard time doing so. Every time I move an app, it keeps reorganizing everything, as I'm not allowed to have empty spots in my home screen, which is very confusing. And when it comes to widgets, I couldn't resize my widgets after adding them. If I want to change the size, I have to remove it first and then add the size I want. Plus, I couldn't place my widgets in the center. Instead, I have to stick to any of the sides. While in Android, I can place any icon or widget anywhere I want on the screen as far as it fits. I can move any app without impacting the position of other apps, and I can resize my widgets after adding them. Next, the keyboard. In Android 11, the keyboard is way more useful than in iOS 14, and here is why. The numbers row is available at the top without the need to download a third-party keyboard. There is a clipboard manager that allows me to pin any text or images I want to keep for future use. I can search for GIFs from within the keyboard in any app I want. I can translate text, adjust the keyboard height, and use the floating keyboard that helps in split screen. While in iOS, it's extremely limited. First, I didn't have the ability to show the numbers row at the top. I couldn't search for online images or GIFs from within the keyboard in third-party apps. It only works in iMessage, and similarly, all other extensions only show up in iMessage. There is no option for resizing, no clipboard manager, and no floating keyboard. I tried to improve the experience on iOS by using a third-party keyboard, and I found SwiftKey delivers the best experience on iOS. Because it has a clipboard manager, a numbers row, and I can search for GIFs in any app I want. Next, the smart camera features. In Android 11, with the help of Google Lens, I can use my camera to copy text, scan the contact information on any business card, search for products, scan QR codes, translate text, and more. In iOS, the only thing I can do with the camera is to scan QR codes, which is very limited. But I was able to get my hands on Google Lens by downloading the Google app, but the experience is not as good because I have to open a separate app for this. Talking about the camera, in iOS, I wasn't able to access the camera settings from within the camera app, which is annoying. Sometimes I need to make sure I have the right settings before taking the shot, and if I want to do this, I have to quit the app, go to settings, locate the camera, and then do what I want. While in Android, I can access the camera settings in a couple of seconds. Next, organizing the quick settings or control center. In iOS, you can only organize the control center icons in settings. While in Android, you can do this right within the quick settings area, which is easier. Next, voice memos. In Android, I use the Google Recorder app, which can identify sounds and transcribe speech on the fly. And the reason why it's important to me because I use it to add captions to my YouTube videos in case YouTube didn't automatically generate one for me. So I play the video, start recording, and wait for it to transcribe my words. Then I take the text from the app and add it to my video on YouTube. But in iOS, the Voice Memos app is very basic. It can only record audio. Next, the default apps. In iOS 14, you have the option to use third-party apps as your default browser or email client, which is better than before, but still limited. In Android, you have a lot more options. You can use a third-party launcher, digital assistant, phone app, messaging app, and the browser. You can also manage the type of links each app can open by default. There are other gaps that Google addressed with Android 11, like the inbuilt screen recorder and the nearby share, which is Android's equivalent to AirDrop. The screen recorder works pretty much the same on both operating systems, but AirDrop was faster than Nearby Share, so if you want to see my detailed comparison between AirDrop and Nearby Share, please click the link showing now on the screen or in the description below. After this very long list of stuff that I missed while using iOS, I found a few things that iOS does better as well. Like the ability to choose the Wi-Fi network or the Bluetooth devices from the control center, something I used to have in Android, but not anymore. The ability to take a full page screenshots in Safari, which is something I'm looking forward to have in Android. And the back tap gesture. That allows me to do certain actions by tapping the back of the device, which is expected to be available in Android but not at the time of filming this video. I still can add this functionality to my Android phone by using an application called TapTap from XDA developers, but certainly it's better to have it built in the OS. So in the ease of use category, stock Android 11 was better by far due to the deep integration of Google Smart Services, which is unmatched in iOS, less restrictions, and more customizations. Next, the ecosystem. And here Apple is better than Google because with Apple's ecosystem, you have the Apple Watch, which is better than smartwatches that use Wear OS. You get better accessories like AirPods Pro, AirPods Max, Beats headphones, and the MagSafe accessories. Apple also offers more services like TV Plus and Fitness Plus. But Google started to scratch the surface by acquiring Nest and Fitbit to have a better ecosystem in the future. And there are a lot of steps in the right direction, like the Chromecast with Google TV, Pixel Buds 2, Google Stadia, and Nest accessories. But they still lag behind in the wearables, so hopefully Fitbit acquisition will do the trick. Finally, the software updates. And in this area, both operating systems were fine. They get day one software updates, which is a draw between the two. So now let's sum up everything. From my experience, I recommend iOS if you are into gaming, if you want a better ecosystem, and care about the visual design of the operating system. While stock Android is for people who want simplicity, to do things faster by utilizing Google Smart Services and the multitasking capabilities, it's also for people who want less restrictions and more customizations. So that's pretty much it for today. That was my comparison between stock Android 11 and the iOS 14. Please let me know in the comments what do you think. So I hope you like my video, and if you do, please hit the thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. Thank you for watching.